fighting it, Laura. You keep fighting. I realize that you've had a tough life, Laura. I realize you've been through some shit, but you got to take the bull by the horns. Okay. I know, but you're complaining now, and you're saying to other people that they destroyed you. They destroyed you. You destroyed it. That is still holds true with your own actions in this community, with what you did. You destroyed it.
I agree.
It may not feel like it right now, but you did. And you have to. Yeah, you did, Laura. You did drugs in your early teens. We know your whole backstory. Okay. You had a tough life. Okay. And you got fucked up. You fucked up in the head, which is whatever. Everyone's fucked up to some degree, but you need to learn your lesson from this and just move on from it. Stop messaging these people, ghost everyone, and just do your content. Hope you can get new people back and try not to make the same mistakes. Don't call CPS on people anymore. And right. Thinking that it's going to stay a secret, especially when you tell people, okay, I got four of you friends here. You're never going to turn on me. Right. And did you know that I called CPS on Makeup Mobster, my biggest enemy? Please never turn on me. I mean, come on, Laura. You had to know eventually it was going to come out. The truth will out, as they say.
Yeah. Well, these people can be shitty people or shitty friends. And you can also have been guilty of doing what you did. Both those things can be true.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, I think I had a pretty nuanced take. Jamie, no real woman wants you. You're all the paths for our.
for our. Well, Honey Bunch wants him, so.
That's right. Yeah. Honey Bunch wants me, so there.
So take that.
Yeah.
So there's that.
I'm allowed to be mad. I'm allowed to have. You're allowed, Laura, but you have to also take responsibility for the fact that you fucked yourself. You did some fuckery, and you can't really be mad that they fucked you over. Because you can't really trust anybody on here, to be honest. Even Lindsay, I fucking side-eye all the time like this.
I'm telling you, I wouldn't trust a fart. I told you.
Yeah. Nope. So, I mean, and again, the only person who called CPS here, Laura, was you, right? And you had to know the consequences that were going to, you know, impact you eventually, right? From that.
Right.
It doesn't matter if it's 3 years ago or 10 years ago. These women around here, especially in the true crime, trauma, whatever, they look at it as like a mortal sin to call CPS, right?
Mm-hmm.
Jamie wants to take all the paths, whatever that means. That's his business. Exactly.
Right.
And it doesn't matter to me, Laura, right? I don't even have kids. But a lot of these women do. A lot of these mothers on here, even the shitty ones, will still get offended if you call CPS. They will consider it to be the biggest sin possible.
But did you own it or were you exposed?
She was exposed.
Okay.
She was exposed and she said that she admits it. But here's the thing. She didn't take full accountability because she didn't say, I'm truly sorry for what I did. And I've made a lot of mistakes and I'm going to try to do better. You know what I mean? It wasn't true accountability. It was more like a defensive, like bitchy accountability. Like, yeah, I did it. She was fucking pissing me off. And so I called CPS on her. So, you know, just don't fucking piss me off. And I won't do that. It was more like that kind of accountability. You're still like not really truly being humble about the situation. You know,
well, can I ask a question, Laura? Are you sorry that you did it? Or are you sorry that it got exposed? Like just asking. Right.
See, and that's the thing.
Being an asshole either.
If she were sorry that she did it, right? Which, by the way, I've seen the messages. She said that she would do it again. So she can't. Yeah, Laura, if you want to come up on the panel, feel free.
I wasn't being an asshole. Ask you that. I was seriously wanting to know.
I like to offer people a chance to get their opinion across. Even though, Laura, I'm banned on your channel, you can comment on my channel because I'm a nice guy.
Are you banned over there?
Yeah, I'm banned. She got angry. At me
I think
time.
You're probably banned more places than I am. And
I just called her the fucking Walter White of Krama and that got me banned.
Did you?
Yeah, that was it. Right, exactly, Rachel. You said it wasn't you for 3 years and let Tiffany Marie take the blame. That's not true. Like, that's not true.
Wait.
Accountability.
Wait. So this whole time for those 3 years, somebody else was blamed?
Yes.
And got a bunch of shit for it?
Yeah, and she just let it happen. She got exposed for it.
Oh. Well, I hope she comes up here. I mean, because I seriously wanted to know. Like, I wasn't even being a smartass. I really wanted to know.
Yes, the Walter White of Krama. Hello, Moon.
Hi, Moon.
Lindsay, get your butt ass off this panel right now. Get the fuck off this panel right now. Lycan, I promise you, dude, you got fucking issues, bro. You're sitting here talking about a baby that got ran over. Lindsay, get your bust ass off this panel right now. I'm opening up my fucking shit as soon as I get home, and I'm running that ass through the motherfucking mud, bitch.
Wait, Moon.
What?
Hold on.
Fuck you. Get off the panel about Steph, bitch.
What?
Oh,
wait, get off the panel about what?
About Steph. Wow. That was not a joke. She was.
I thought she was kidding.
She was threatening you. Ooh,
no,
wow.
It wasn't a threat. She was telling me to get down. It was not a threat.
No, she said, I'm going to bust open all my shit on you because you're up here talking about Steph and
I didn't say anything bad.
It doesn't matter. Point is, you were up here on my panel while I was talking about it.
Okay. Well, okay. I'm staying up here. She wants to come back. I'd like to hear what she has to say.
Oh, boy. Didn't expect that.
No, I thought she was kidding.
Stop smoking crack, Moon. But what about that hooker that fucks for crack? What about that hooker, huh?
I don't want to start with the insults against Moon.
Honestly, I hope karma fucks you both like a hooker fucks for crack. That's perfect. I love that shit. Anyway, Laura, if you want to come back, come on panel. Feel free. Didn't expect that. Oh, she actually came up. Hello, Laura.
Hello, Laura.
Hello. Hello. Are you there?
I think you're muted, Laura.
I think she's just sitting there judging us.
Hello.
You think you're higher class than me, Laura? Listen, I can get a much nicer coat than you can, Laura, okay? Much nicer coat. And jewelry. Alrighty.
Good talk.
You know how much nicer shit I could get than you? I could probably get a nicer fucking house, too. What do you think about that? You guys need to stop dealing with Moon seriously. Yeah, I just tried to, like, be nice and hopefully...
Well, I thought she had... I don't know why she was... Maybe she was talking... I don't know why she was mad at me.
It's such a nice thing. I've gotten no donations so far. What the fuck?
It's because I'm up here.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, we hear you now, yes.
All right. Sorry, my dog disconnected my microphone.
Oh, okay.
So I want to straighten out a couple of things that I think is important to straighten out. One, Tiffany was not getting the blame for 3 years. That is a blatant lie. I was good friends with Tiffany. When after I did it, I realized I fucked up. But I wasn't going to say anything. If I was trying to keep it so secretive, I wouldn't have told anyone. But the people that had outed it were the same people that were like, she fucking deserved it, blah, blah, blah. The one that was on your panel.
Why did you out that?
Hold on. Because I'm not like that. I did say it at one point, but I don't release private messages. I don't talk about private combos.
But you have released private stuff before.
Oh, no, I don't. Oh, no, I don't. Very, very rarely will I release
private. Well, why not in this case? It would at least prove that they're being hypocrites.
I know they're being hypocrites. That's why I ignore them.
Why don't you fucking defend yourself?
I have.
Show the fucking messages. Show that they were glad that,
but it doesn't
that you called CPS.
It doesn't matter. Don't you get it? It just doesn't matter. And like you saying that have I ever showed private screenshots? Of course I have. I mean, who hasn't? But I'm saying on a general, no, I normally don't. Someone sends me a private message, I'm not going to fucking go release it to everybody because I'm so right. scared. I got to hide. And that's the kind of show I'm talking
so about. You don't release private messages, but you'll make fake calls to CPS to impact someone's child and family. I mean, that's okay, a good
first
point.
First of all, that was 3 years ago. If I called now, that would be a different story. But it was 3 years ago. What my mind frame was 3 years ago is not what it is today. I am not. You said that I didn't apologize. Yes, I did. I apologized.
Yeah, but it wasn't a genuine apology. You weren't really sorry.
I gave her a genuine apology. I don't owe the community a genuine apology. It had nothing to do with them. Who I owed a genuine apology to was her. That's who I owed a genuine apology.
But you're still going back and forth with her and you're still talking
shit. No, I'm not going back and forth.
You are. I saw your fucking community post that you made, the whole long diatribe.
I made one community post for 12 days. I'm sorry, 4 fucking years of her coming at me every motherfucking day. And in the last 12 days, I haven't said fucking boo. And every day she's coming after me and I haven't said fucking boo. When this got released and she tried to say that I threatened her, I didn't fucking threaten Tara. There was absolutely no threat in there.
But no, I agree with you on that. You did not threaten her. I stuck up for you on that. That was not a threat.
And, you know, people talk about, oh, you're publicly exposed. Do you know how many people are exposed and still fucking lie about it?
Right. Oh, yes. There's a lot of them.
Mm-hmm. And I don't. I own it. I owned it. But no matter what the situation was, people were just not going to be happy. And I fucking, everyone keeps saying I didn't acknowledge it. I absolutely took accountability. The first time, second time, third time, fourth time that I went live about it. Initially, I had a knee-jerk reaction. Initially, I was like, woke up and I heard this is getting outed. You have to understand something too. I was so close with these people. I trusted them with everything. I never in my wildest dreams thought they would do something like this. I know their deepest secrets. They know my deepest secrets.
Okay, but you're acting like they committed the bigger sin, but you're CPS.
Hold on. I'm saying
they just hold a secret.
What I'm saying is that even now, I still haven't released any of their secrets. I still haven't released anything from them, but I was shocked on that initial reaction. My initial reaction was a knee-jerk reaction based on shock, based on, you know, surprise, based on holy fuck. That's when I woke up. I found out like 5 minutes later, I wrote, did a live, honesty is the best policy. And I hadn't even had time to think about anything. That was a knee-jerk reaction.
Would you do it again? Would you call CPS again?
Okay. The answer is no. But to solidify that even more, you have to understand, this bitch has talked about me every fucking day for 4 years. Every single motherfucking day. She's attacked my kid. No, you don't. She's attacked my kids. She's attacked my business. She's attacked my life. She's attacked my looks. She's for 4 fucking years. And in the last 3, I have never called CPS. So for anyone to ask me, would you call? It's a little frustrating because I would have. If I was going to, I would have fucking done it already because of how much this bitch has done.
But you wouldn't do it today, probably because you would probably get caught.
No.
You know?
There's a lot more context to that text.
I will say I don't think there was any need for them to send that latest message out. But I will say it's still on you because you know you can't trust these people.
Yeah, but I'm saying that I thought I could trust them. But I didn't
write
that message. But I didn't write that message thinking either she was going to send it or not send it or give it out. I don't give a fuck.
Oh, I know there's a message of her saying she'd do it again.
Yes, but there's more context to that message. That message was also a year ago, but there's more context to that.
To be fair, that message is from a year ago. So I will admit that. Maybe she's changed her opinion since then. Who knows?
There's context to it. Again, if I wanted to do it again, I would have.
Laura, here's something I've been wanting to ask you. Here's something I wanted to ask you since this whole thing happened. Hold on.
Let me also say, if you go back to MM's live, none of the stuff when the call originally happened and she said what was stated, none of it was what what's his name came up with. So unless MM proves that that's what was said, then everyone's running with something that fucking Isaac came up with, because MM never said that. And I didn't believe that I said that. And if you go back to MM's original live, she never said that. Just saying.
Wait, said what?
That I said that father was watching porn with the son or whatever.
I see. So you didn't report that to CPS?
I don't remember reporting that. No. But again, it was 3 years ago. I don't.
But you also said did you report that she was driving drunk in her car with her child?
I don't remember that either.
But you did say it on live streams back then, right?
What?
You said it on live streams back then.
No, I didn't.
That she was driving. Yeah, you did. You said it a lot.
No, I didn't. I never said she was driving drunk with a kid in the car on live streams.
Put a one in the chat if you guys recall that she said this on her streams.
Show me the proof.
I also have a new poll. I have a new poll. Do you think Laura took true accountability for the CPS call? Yes or no? You know, Steph needs CPS. Yeah, I'll leave that one alone. That's what Mega Monster said. The trolls said.
Yeah, Daria's been around. She knows. Then show me a recording of it, Witchy. MM doesn't even drink. So there's no recordings of me saying this on a live stream. MM doesn't even drink. I used to be very good friends with her. I know she doesn't drink alcohol. So no, I never said that on a live. That is a blatant fucking lie. Hey, Robbie.
Okay, well, I wanted to ask another question.
Shoot.
So when it comes to Mega Mobster talking about you all the time years ago, why wasn't one of your thoughts...
No, she does it now. Not years ago. She does this now.
Okay, but you said that she was going at you all the time back then. Yeah, and that's why you called CPS.
Nothing's changed.
Okay, hold on. So she talked about you all the time, right? As she does now. Why wasn't one of your thoughts to go get a restraining order on her or something like that? Laura has muted. I mean, relatively simple question.
Fucking dog. My God.
Your dog. Okay. Did you hear the question?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because we didn't, back in 2019 to 2021, that's just not what we did.
But you called CPS?
there were a lot of CPS calls. And it wasn't just me.
So you had to join in and
do no. What too. The whole point was, cool thank kid. You, Rachel. The whole point was, and people that know the situation that were around mm-hmm. then are going to understand what I'm about to say. It wasn't that, oh, she was talking shit. It was so beyond that. And it was so much deeper than that. But I don't need to explain everything. But I'm going to for you, Lycan. MM and I used to be very good friends. Mm-hmm. And because we were very good friends, the fact that she wouldn't shut the fuck up was like, it hurt. And the way our friendship fell out, it hurt. And I just wanted it to stop. I mean, we're talking every fucking day for over a year. And my thought process, right or wrong, my thought process was she had gotten swatted. Some people say it was MGL. Nobody really knows who it was. But she had gotten swatted. Her husband made her stay off the internet for a couple of months. So my thought process was, if CPS shows up, she will shut the fuck up. And her husband will make her get off the fucking internet. And I will get some peace for at least a couple of months. That was my thought process. I'm not saying I'm right, but it's mm-hmm. that was my thought process. I just wanted her to shut the fuck up.
I see. Well, it was very ill-advised. I'm sure you know that by now.
Yeah. But like the reason why I have, why it seems like I have this, like lackadaisical attitude or whatever, is mainly because she's gonna knock us out again. Go away. Mainly because one, I took accountability for it. Two, I know what I did was wrong, and I know that I should have never done that, but I can't change it today. All I can do 3 years ago after it was done was, okay, I can't change it. I can't take it back. I can't do anything to change it. So I made peace with it and I moved on. And 3 years later, it comes up, but I moved on from it already. Like, and I'm not saying she couldn't be like, you know, oh my God, we finally know. She thought it was me all along to begin with. I was accused of it 1,000 times. So that was her justification for coming after me every day, coming after my business, coming after this. Well, now that she knows I called, she still doesn't shut the fuck up. She's that obsessed. And it's frustrating. It's aggravating. But what do? I ignore her. I apologize.
But you keep kind of, but you keep kind of talking about this stuff too on your channel.
Because I don't. Oh no, I don't like him.
And you're even talking about it here, which, you know, great having you up here. But still, it's adding to the you know, fuel to the fire.
Oh well. What would you like me to do? People talk about it. I want to straighten things out. For some reason, the community, not my supporters, because I already gave a heartfelt apology to my true supporters, but trolls think I owe them an apology. I don't owe them an apology. It has nothing to do with them. It had to do with me and MM, period. End of story. That's all it had to do with.
Skinwalker, who's that?
That MM. MM, Alicia, there's a few of them.
Maybe they just love you. They love making content out of you.
Oh, it's they copied my business, for fuck's sake.
Mm.
I mean, like, ridiculous.
Well, I think you should just like stop feeding it and move on from it.
I don't feed it. I haven't even talked about it in over 10 days.
Well, you have to keep going forever.
I do, but my point is, you had my name in the title.
Yes, I did. But you have to ignore everyone talking about you, Laura. That's what it's about.
Okay, Lycan.
And you heard my take. I wasn't even unfair to you, was I?
No, you weren't. But you didn't know the whole story. It's not like.
Yeah, and a lot of people don't know the whole story, you know. There's a lot of stuff in private, I'm sure, that will stay private as well. You know, people are not going to tell all the sides that make them look bad, right? Just the parts that make you look bad. So I get that there's, you know, more than one side to every story.
Purple Penny, I've never seen you in my entire life. So don't act like you're a supporter of mine. You're not a supporter of mine. I don't know who the fuck you are. And my supporters, my true supporters, got a heartfelt apology. I don't owe the general public an apology for something that has absolutely nothing to do with them.
Well, they didn't say they were a supporter of yours, but they said the people who support your channel have a right to know.
Exactly.
I know. I wouldn't know any fucking trolls an apology either. I mean, if they really are like just trolls coming at you, then fuck them, you know, just ignore them.
But I do ignore like 90% of all the shit that's said. If I didn't, I would lose my mind. I would literally lose my mind. Me? No, I'm not over Tiffany's at all.
No, I think she's talking about Ms. Brazzi.
There was something else you said that there's something else that I want to address that you got wrong. I forgot what it was. Oh, shit. Now I forgot. Oh, as far as the letter goes, I wrote that letter because I was aggravated and I was pissed off. And I'm human, just like anybody else who writes an ex-friend or an ex-boyfriend or an ex-girlfriend or whatever the situation for, you know, you haven't spoken to them in a month and something triggered you and you wrote them because you're pissed off. That's all I did. That's all that letter was. Mm-hmm. It wasn't, you know, the fact that she ran and made it public, it just shows me everything I need to know. And
I do think that was a little fucked up. Should have probably just remained between you guys, but it is YouTube and people are going to exploit every little thing, especially when they know it gets them attention or donations. So at the end of the day, you have to look out for yourself and think about what your actions are going to, what impact they're going to have.
I have a theory. And Purple Penny, you're entitled to your opinion. I really don't give a fuck what your opinion is of me. My theory, and I stick by this, and I said this on, I think, the second or third live that I did about, you know, way back when this happened, when, you know, when it all got exposed, is, again, I can't take back what I did. I am truly sorry to the people I support that supported me, that, you know, had my back, that thought, how could I, you know, how could you do this? And I am truly sorry to them. But every once in a while, you still get that shock moment. You still get that, what in the fuck? You know, why did this happen? Why did they do this? Exactly, Daria. You know, why did they do this? And, you know, then the rumors started and all these things started. And my whole thing was, if all these people thought I was so horrible in the first place, well, then, okay, they just got confirmation. Now you could shut the fuck up and move on. Or... on the flip side is, if I'm such a real lifer, why are you still running your mouth? If I'm such
a good, that's a good point.
Why are you still running your mouth?
That's a good point. I've always thought if someone's going to call you dangerous or like they do really fucked up things to people, why do you keep talking about them? Right.
Yeah.
If
notice a threat. Notice how few people talk about Isaac. Notice how few people talk about Savage. There's a reason, because they're known real lifers and people don't want them going real life, but you got the mandolins, the MMs, they don't shut the fuck up about me. So don't tell me that I'm so dangerous and I'm such a real lifer when you don't shut the fuck up, because I don't see you talking about true real lifers. That's where some of my aggravation comes from too. Because again, I was very good friends with MM. She knows I'm not a fucking real lifer. She knows that this was an isolated incident and that I came out of character, and people that know me, like really know me, know that too. Even subs that know me know that too.
I will say that that stupid bitch Amanda, she's got no room to talk because she's went at people's families as well. She even doxed my mother on her community wall, or actually was on Hooker's. She was in under Hooker's account, and she doxed my mother's Facebook. She was like stalking my mother's Facebook and posted something from my mom's Facebook onto Hooker's community wall. So she has no room to talk about any of this or criticize anybody. Apparently, she and Hooker also went after Hello Starlight's father, like threatening to contact him and stuff. I mean, so they're scum. Fuck them.
She talked about him every day for like 3 years too, until she met Hooker. Then all of a sudden it stopped. But I ignored her. Like, I always thought she was my CPS caller number one, so I just pretty much ignored her. If I really think that you called CPS on me, I'll probably never mention you again.
That's what was said, that Hooker stalked me to it was a coffee shop, and that was said to Scotty. I don't know if it's true or not because I never saw proof of it. But let me thank some people for donating so far. Thank you so much to KD Show for the $20, and thank you also to Steph for the $5. She or he says, "For your chat smells like ammonia and monkeypox." Well, I appreciate that. Let me play a little clip for you guys. You can't tell by the way I use my walk, I'm a woman's man, no time to talk. Music loud, women walk, women kick around, this is how I was born. Have a party room, that's okay, and you may look the other way.
I want to know which AI program he used for that, because that was great.
Yeah, there's some AI programs that are pretty good out there. Becca Chu, here's the thing. When that was said, that Hooker followed me to a coffee shop, first off, I never really went to a regular coffee shop over there. So she couldn't have followed me because I wasn't in one to even be followed there. That's the crazy part. Like, because it was said that she saw me at the coffee shop and was like watching and was going to like pull a gun on me or something. But it's like, how would that happen when I wasn't even at one ever? Doesn't make no sense. That's why I said it was made up, because I'm like, what? That's ridiculous.
Or here's another thing, like Wyoming. Hey, Wyoming. Jim Terry. How come nobody ever talks about Jim Terry and all the shitty shit he's done to people? Why? Because he's a real lifer.
Jim Terry. Who's that again?
Wyoming knows what I mean.
Hooker drinks coffee as you're more as a high calorie McFlurry type of dude. Oh, she loves her McFlurries, especially the Oreo ones. Yeah, I doubt that happened. Hey, Lindsay, welcome back.
Jim Terry is a diehard real life.
I'm waiting till y'all wrap that up and then, because I can't stay long, but okay. I wanted to say something before
already for fuck's sake.
Okay. Well, it doesn't have anything to do with Laura, but I just wanted to say, you know, before I came up here, I said I did not feel comfortable judging Stephanie's parenting. Did I not, James? And you and I are two totally separate people, correct?
Yes.
Okay. And I would also like to say that if Moon has something to say or has something to add to the conversation, that's fine. That's great. But to order me off a panel and to talk to me like that, I'm sick of it. I don't talk to her that way. I don't treat her that way. And it's bullshit. You know, telling me, demanding I get off a panel and saying, how dare I, and all this shit. You know, I thought she was kidding when she first came up. You know, and I would have,
me too.
You know, if she wanted to have something to say or disagree, that's fine. But I'm done being talked to like a fucking bitch. Okay.
Good. Good, Lindsay. So, it's good.
You know,
good
I'm not, no, and I don't, yourself. I don't want to, I'm not shit talking Moon. It's nothing like that, you know? And if she wanted to say how, you know, she totally disagrees with what I'm saying, fine. That's fine. But there's a way to talk to people and there's a way not to. And I show her respect and I'm tired of being disrespected and talked to like shit like that. Sorry.
What happened? Who is that? Who was that? I don't know anyone in your
family. No, that just really pissed me off because, again, you know what I mean? Like, me and James are totally different people. I said what I had to say. I'll stand by it. I think it was dangerous of Stephanie to be live streaming while following an ambulance right after her son got hit by a car, right? Mm-hmm. I said, I hoped your son was okay. I said, to be fair, she might have taken her car because if she went in the ambulance, then she'd be stuck at the hospital without transportation. But even even if I had attacked her parent, or even if I, whatever I said, there's a way to talk to people and a way not to talk to people. Mm-hmm. And I'm tired of being ordered around and talked to like shit when I don't do that in return. So.
Well, I'm.